In this video, I'm talking to Nico from Morning Fame about YouTube analytics and how we can improve our channels and our videos to rank them higher on YouTube. All and more coming up. Hey there, and welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com, teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and today I'm joined by Nico from Morning Fame, the tool Morning Fame, which is a new YouTube analytics tool that helps us creators here on YouTube to rank our YouTube videos higher and help us to improve our overall performance of our channels so we can have a greater impact on our viewers just like you. So welcome, Nico.
Hi, it's a pleasure to be here. Actually, I'm also a total data nerd, I could say, and seeing your channel is like a delight.
Thank you, and it's really great because to have you here, I reached actually out because I bought the tool just a few weeks ago, and I saw how well you have actually put the data together. Maybe we can talk a little bit about first, how does YouTube actually rank videos, and what do you think are the basic metrics that a creator just like myself need to look at when we want to rank a video higher on YouTube search results?
Absolutely. I mean, YouTube, you can say it's a little bit simpler than Google, I would say, comparatively. And there are a few important metrics that YouTube looks at. And one metric that is the most important one, according to a study done by Matt Gielen, you can put a link into the description if you want. Very interesting is how many people are led to the video from outside onto YouTube. So YouTube wants a lot of audience on the site. So if your channel is doing so, like for example, you send some emails out when you published a new video and people go into YouTube, this is a very important metric for YouTube to know, all right, this is a good video, I will promote it even more in all the different means that YouTube has. By the way, it's not only YouTube search, like Google search, but also suggested videos. You know, those videos at the site alongside a video you're just watching, and all other, like the home screen and so on. So YouTube has a lot of ways to promote your videos, and leading more new viewers to the platform is one important part. The second most important part is watch time. Watch time means similar, we talked about that on my channel, right? It's similar to how long people stay on your website. So in this case, it's about the video, how long do people watch the video? It's quite common that they abort watching a video in the middle because they got bored or something, you know, the video is not that great, and they don't watch it to the end. And YouTube measures that first and foremost to find out whether people are really really enjoying the video. So something like you would argue maybe thumbs up and comments and subscriptions, all that stuff that people can engage with your video, they are actually not so important. So it's more watch time. So people should ideally watch to the end.
That's very interesting. I mean, Google and YouTube is a property of Google, right? It's not our own website, and we can't do anything to improve watch time in the sense that, we can improve watch time by having a better video, but the data itself is provided by Google. We can see that in our YouTube analytics, and then act accordingly and try to improve that. Now, this is also a metric that is not easily gamed, right? I can't buy links like on Google and try to game my search results through that. So that's very, very interesting. So how much data does YouTube actually give you in that regard in the YouTube analytics? Are you satisfied with what you can see there?
Yeah, actually, it's still overwhelming if you look at YouTube analytics as first. I mean, you guys know it's probably from Google Analytics as well. That's certainly overwhelming, but still it's quite condensed to just a few things that are really, really valuable. The watch time is very well thought out in YouTube's analytics, where you can see where people stop watching the video, so you can go to this position in the video and look at what were you talking about that in this video at that point. Maybe that was boring and you should cut out a scene in the future where you don't do an excerpt that is not interesting to your viewers. Anyway, this is very interesting to see, and also, of course, traffic sources. This is very valuable because you can see there where people are coming from. And from Google Analytics, you know, that is Facebook and all the other websites where people are coming from. But also on YouTube, you can see all the internal traffic sources. So the ways YouTube can promote your video, and that is YouTube search. You can even see there which search terms they used in order to find your video. Suggested video, you can see which other videos brought you those views to your video. And all the other places, like the home screen, which people see first when they log into YouTube or open the YouTube app.
Okay, so that's very interesting. Now, as a creator, as myself, I bought a tool from your company, Morning Fame, and I'm also going to link up the YouTube channel down below.
Thank you.
With Morning Fame, I saw that you run additional analysis on the data set that you have available through YouTube API, right? So
yeah,
what is actually the data that you bring into your tool?
Yeah, true. If you look at YouTube Analytics in raw, what YouTube is providing to you, usually what you first look at is, of course, views, right? And you can do much more with this data to understand what really resonates with the audience. You have to understand, I mean, it's the same for web pages, of course, right?
Yeah.
You want to provide some content that your viewers, your visitors are really enjoying.
Mm-hmm.
And on YouTube, that is not only each individual video, but a more broader pattern. That means, in particular, the video topic. For example, I do a channel where I talk about YouTube SEO. And what I found out is, of course, that when I talk about the YouTube algorithm, then people are really enjoying that. All my videos about the YouTube algorithm, they are really doing great. So I'm, of course, doing more videos about the algorithm, explain how it works internally, and maybe some nuggets where I explain how to improve your own videos to better get promoted by YouTube. So extracting which video topic works well with your audience, what my audience enjoys watching, that is really valuable, and you usually don't see that by just looking at the views. You also have to take into account, do they watch those videos to the end? Do they engage by giving thumbs up and commenting? Because that's, of course, like the tip of the iceberg. Not all people will write a comment, but if they do, that's really a sign that they really enjoyed the video, right? So taking all that into consideration, you can further analyze which video topics work well with your audience, mm-hmm. and do more of those. And that actually I built into the software, looking at all the different metrics at the same time to see which topics work best.
Maybe can you tell us a little bit more about what your tool or how you get people to that point of actually taking action? What do you do in the tool, giving them different visualizations, giving them different tips? How did you think about this when you thought about, because on this channel we also tell people about the data that they can gather, but then they also need to take the next step of implementing this, taking action upon the data, changing something in their business. So how did you think about this when you built your tool?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, besides choosing the proper video topic to do more of, there's also one interesting part. You know, you don't have that too much on websites, but on YouTube, the thumbnail, the picture you see before you watch the video, this one is really important. You can compare that to a magazine cover, right? You are buying the magazine because at the grocery store you see the magazine cover and it's looking nice, so you buy it. And the same is for the thumbnail for the video, and improving this thumbnail to make it really intriguing that the viewers click on this video is really important. First of all, because people are then more intrigued to watch the video. And second, of course, because the YouTube algorithm also tracks the click-through rate. We don't have, unfortunately, access to this information, but anyway, it is important for the YouTube SEO. And the thumbnail is very crucial to this process, because if your thumbnail can stick out, between all the other videos that a viewer sees, for example, on the YouTube search result page, then they will rather click your video instead of the other videos.
Right.
So I built a neat report where you can see for your video that you just published 24 hours after you published a new video, you see five other thumbnails of videos that rank alongside your video, along with your own thumbnail, and you can compare. Does your thumbnail stick out? Is it visually more attractive than the other thumbnails? Because if you can achieve that, yeah, then you win the click instead of the other videos. And improving that will boost your overall success of your video.
Absolutely. Yeah, that's really, really interesting. I think that what we can do for this video is maybe I will publish this video, then 24 hours or 48 hours later, I will get an email from your tool telling me what I've done well on this video. Or maybe I can link up a screenshot down below so people can see what data is actually on this report. And you can learn from this, maybe even for your Google Analytics reports or what you tell your client, because this is what really matters for us YouTubers to take the next action to improve our channel. And maybe that will give you ideas later on for your analytics and how you display and visualize data later on as well.
Absolutely, and I think one big issue you usually have into conveying whether you did a good job or not, right, is whether the new videos you publish on a channel are getting better and better, more successful. And there is one interesting effect. In the long run, your video may accumulate thousands of views, and that is of course a success, but you want to know your results immediately. And that is also the reason why Morning Fame sends you 24 hours after you published a new video this report that you will be linking up, because then you can see how the views of that video grew. And it's quite interesting to see. I'm studying this view increase in the first 24 hours for countless channels, and it's usually the case that you can already tell after 24 hours whether this video will be a big success or not.
Yeah.
And so this is a good way to measure whether you are improving over time, and also something you can show to your boss.
Well, I don't have a boss, but that's great to hear. I think that in the end we can really learn from what the tool, even if you're not a YouTuber, you can learn from how Nico has built these visualizations, how he has packed information into a short email that was really actionable to me. And that's why we got talking, because I was like, wow, this is a really great report for me. And maybe you can build a report for the stuff that you are doing for your website or for your business that you doing analytics. All right. Great information. Thank you, Nico, for this valuable insights. Where can people find more out about you and find your channel and so on?
Absolutely. You can go to my website. That is Morning Fame, morningfa.me. Quite complicated, but anyway, you'll find a link in the description, or check out my channel called Morning Fame, where I talk about YouTube SEO quite a lot. And you can learn a little bit more about how to optimize your videos.
We also did a video for your channel, so I'm gonna also link that up right here, so you can head over what I have said on his channel, because we were talking a little bit about what are the similarities between website SEO and YouTube SEO, and how we could maybe transfer the learning over. So if you're interested in that, check out that video as well. All right, now you heard Nico. If you have any more questions, and if you want to give Google a good signal to rank us higher, or YouTube to rank us higher, then leave a comment down below. And if you haven't yet, then consider subscribing to this channel, because we'll bring you new videos every week. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.
Cheers.